there's a strong sense of a duty to care. We need to work with families, with the caregivers, to make sure that the duty to care is there, even though we've accepted that we cannot cure. So you'll hear bouncing back and forth between cure and care. So you are indeed still caring for your family member, even though we've talked, we've looked at it, we realize we cannot cure. We've accepted we're actually only got so much energy, so much time. If we spend it on a cure which is just not there, care will suffer, and that dying process, the dying experience, will be not a good one. Within Catholicism, there is the concept of a good death. There is the sense that a certain amount of suffering is there, despite what we do. I've been told it's part of what Jesus went through with the crucifixion. Not all of us have to go through that one, so we talk about that. We know that it cannot be completely pain-free, the process, but if we say, okay, how can we best care, because that's what we're about, we're caring in this culture, that often opens the door to many of the interventions and allows us to close the door to, let's say, it should happen within a hospital setting, that my relative said at home, so we're going to do it at home. And actually, some of the cases that we as physicians work with help us learn, help change us. And in my time, I've cared for priests who've been down the palliative pathway. And a few have been remarkably ready to go down that pathway. It's been quite something.